All right, so we are gathering gear from my basement. We are heading over to the where we are going to test our setup for the APNC live stream. So
you're gonna have to edit that.
Why?
We're going over to the venue.
Oh.
From all the
sorry.
It's trade secret.
Trade secret. Take that out. All right. Run it back.
Put the thing over your mouth. They're like, beep. We're heading over to the beep.
We are heading over to our venue this morning to test out the live stream setup for APNC, which is a big live stream job that we're coming to do pretty soon. We're doing two for APNC specifically.
We are testing the setup for APNC, which is going to mimic the environment that we're going to have at the conference center for this client.
You see this quality, super high quality packing job?
Oh yeah. That is packing.
Quality.
It's like we have so much stuff, but because your truck is so big, it makes it look like it's really not that much.
Yep.
Boom. We're going on a trip
in our giant
rocket
shuttle van.
That's like the new theme song for your truck. What'd you say? What'd you say about my mama? It's only right to get coffee before production. So we're going to one of Micah's favorite spots, and I gotta admit it's becoming
Kyle's
one of my
coffees.
Yep, Kyle's
boy
coffee.
Knows what he's doing with the coffee.
Show enough. And Micah shot his some of the portraits that are up in there, right? Yep.
Shot for his spread for Kernersville magazine.
Nice. Micah won't brag on himself, but I will.
So thank you.
Finished Kyle's coffee. Well, I've got mine in my hand. Micah killed it. He already had his. It's done.
Woo!
It's gone. All right, we're now here in our discreet location, getting ready to set up. So let's get the rundown. What are we doing?
This is what you're gonna be setting up right here. So there's the room setup. And then this will be slightly different because we only have the normal ATEM. We don't have the extreme.
Uh-huh.
But you'll get the idea.
If it makes sense that what I put on there actually a person is capable of doing.
Let's see if I'm capable. Micah made the setup, so I have to read it, interpret it, and then set it up. Let's see what happens.
These are the Blackmagic Pro 4K studio cameras. You put a lens on them just like you would any other DSLR. Take back caps off, line up the red dots.
Yep. Thank you. They won't, but here will, because yes. That sub.
Yes, just to communicate with each other.
That sub,
they talk
to them, but the main
through a microphone.
So this finger,
even though they're right next to each other.
How this finger behaves
yes,
here.
Yes, that is what happens.
This is for the other place. So this is like a second
problem.
Second,
solving.
Correct. But.
Kintail, he's the English teacher.
Oh, I can tell.
I'm the one that's like, no, Mike, you need to say it this way or nobody's gonna know.
But I know I have a degree in communications.
Yeah.
Do you know I have a comm degree?
I'm an English
teacher. Yeah, that's why you do something that makes money because. And you're good at like making stuff happen.
Do you know which comm area? Did I ever tell you?
No.
You wanted to guess? Which comm area?
Terry, know there was areas.
So. Oh yes,
like mine.
Explain
that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So we are the, I tell people we're, I'm the few, the proud that do my study.
I want you to explain it. Go.
I try to talk, but they
I do. Oh, I listen to you. I'm always.
So, correct me if I'm wrong, Micah, but we are receiving video audio from there to this laptop.
Okay.
We're using the in both okay. ends from uh-huh. this laptop.
Okay.
Out to the projector.
Okay.
And back to the mixer to the speakers.
Oh wow, that's pretty awesome.
Okay. So
you're splitting it at here to the speakers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Everything, the speakers, everything is muted on this laptop, and we're using this laptop solely as an out for these microphones to him over there. We did that in the board because we split in the board the channels. So our main
check
volume for these mics,
check 1 2,
which we're hearing here,
check 1 2,
is separate from.
You're having to mute back and forth.
Now watch this. Watch check. This. No, and here's why.
Check 1 2.
This
check, 1 2.
Toggle right here
check, 1 2.
Is what's going out here because check, 1 2. We rerouted these mics check, 1 2. To two places. These check, mics go to sub 1 and 2, check, and they go to the main.
Check.
The main is in this room.
Check, check, 1 2.
Sub 1 and 2. He
check,
cannot
1 2.
Hear us now. But we can
check
hear
one,
us.
Two.
Now he can hear us and we can
check
hear
one,
us.
Check 1 2. Go ahead and check.
We split the audio.
What? That, like, I couldn't figure out how to get in the parking lot. I think I had
rocking
to go
out.
Through that intersection.
Yes.
Huh?
The little foam stick. It's gone.
It fell off.
We could get enough.
Once we start moving, I guess.
Best
didn't get me while I was moving.
Oh, I didn't. You're shaking the whole van.
This seems like a place where you would have a rap music video.
Why, just because there's graffiti?
A hip-hop. Doesn't this seem like a place where hip-hop would be
really bad? Let me see if you're actually getting it yet.
You know what's awesome about this camera?
I'm gonna try and do the YouTube carry. Let's see if I can get it.
The YouTube carry. The houseman. That's what that is right there.
We call this the houseman. Welcome to the houseman. In honor of you.
In honor of me. You ever just slam on on the brakes and pull off to the side of the road when you see all the beams and all the lights coming through the clouds and everything.
Good morning, Ryan.
Good morning, Leonard.
What are you doing?
Wrapping up the cable.
You rap?
No.
Look at Ryan's rapping skills.
Rapping skills, mainly because we wanted to watch a movie last night. But we couldn't just watch it regularly on a TV. We had to have an extra speaker.
Because awesome. We're here for the audio.
We're here for the audio experience.
Boss. Packing up to head home.
That's giving him my floral suitcase.
Because it's like I have to take him for a walk and I have to get my kids on the bus. Mm-hmm. I at least have to go for a walk in the morning. Good. I usually do a couple miles with him.
Don't record this, Kevin will be mad.
No, you get the pink stuff.
I'm Tim.
Aspartame.
I can't tell Kevin. Kevin knows. I put a little bit of coffee in my creamer.
APNC and we are grabbing lunch. Do a 360. 360.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
Been walking around town for about, what, 15, 20?
Too long.
And every restaurant we've tried to go to so far has been closed. So, and they're all the Japanese restaurants. So apparently for some reason all the Japanese restaurants are getting shut down out here. So we're heading back and we're gonna get sandwiches instead. Sandwiches it be. The sandwich shop was a what?
Bust.
And so, the other two Asian places that we went to were closed.
So now we're trying to find somewhere else. So everything is literally either closed or it's a bar.
But there's so many people, I don't understand.
It's just not good.
People don't eat.
It was like a snack shop. The sandwich place was like snacks.
Is it straight?
Turn.
Which way?
Left.
Okay. Left is this way, bro.
My left.
His left.
Your other left. Don't trip on flip-flops.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Bold Rock, this was our next choice. Let's see what happens. Are they open or are they not? They are. Yay, they're open.
We found an open restaurant. And it is a brewery.
Or are we gonna go find something?
So it may not even be worth it.
I have never had this much trouble finding a restaurant while being surrounded by restaurants.
Surrounded.
Yeah.
So what do you think? Are we gonna do it or no? Well, I guess we're walking again.
Burger Ashville. That sounds good.
Very limited menu.
All right, here we go. Next one. Here we go.
At least I found a place that was open.
It was open, so that was a start.
All right, strike. What are we on?
We get a walk. Four. It's building. The other press
I like
building.
Ours better.
I think so. They're open. Food that is open. Yay. And actually food. And it's not a brewery.
I was just pointing out the fact that their wording says their cows were never fed antibiotics.
Injected is not on there.
I don't...
Semantics.
You got the good stuff, huh?
All the good stuff.
I get the classic.
Kombucha, kombucha,
mint pineapple.
It's pretty good.
Minty fresh.
Yeah.
It tastes exactly like you'd think it would. It tastes like mint pineapple.
All right, what's up?
So basically, you don't want to drink coffee right after you have something that has like a lot of carbs or sugar off the bat, because carbs and sugar, it's going to spike your blood sugar, right? Uh-huh. And your body will, you know, it'll take a bit of time for it to release a whole bunch of insulin to combat it, right? And if you add coffee to the mix, what it does is that it's actually going to release a little bit of adrenaline, and that adrenaline is basically going to tell your body to release even more insulin. So basically, if we were to look at a graph, you know, normally if you were to just eat this kind of food and have it with some soda and whatnot, you know, it would go above a certain point where you would start to feel tired for no reason, you know, kind of what we would call a sugar crash. But if we add coffee to the mix, on the down part, it would actually make the down part happen a lot more sooner and some more intense, to the point that you actually go below like your bottom point of you would also feel tired in terms of like how much glucose you have here in your body, you know. That's why sometimes when you eat food, you know, like something that's like really like sugary or has a lot of carbs, you know, like half an hour afterwards, you know, you just feel really tired, you know, yeah. You know, or you know, that kind of explains why on a lot of Sundays, you know, everybody just wants to take a fat nap after lunch, you know.
Makes sense. It's interesting.
I'm about it.
You still want to get some coffee or no?
Just wait until we're swerving off the road.
Are you going to enjoy this, Ryan?
I don't know. Is the camera going to watch me eat it?
Yes.
So yummy.
Yeah, I'm kind of waiting.
No.
Oh.
Yeah.
What do you think of your burger, Micah?
I don't know. I haven't tried it yet. I got the Daily Burger, which is a grass-fed
disease.
The game I like to call first in inches. It's where we fit this van in this parking garage with literally like that much clearance on the top.
The first time.
Will we make it?
Siphon.
I'm gonna go sit down and look fancy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Delicious.